asked you guys on Twitter to tell me the most disturbing thing you've ever done in The Sims, and I regret it very much.
I want my mommy.
Accidentally trapped a Sim in an endless time loop where they died over and over and over, forever burning alive. Built a fire basement full of fireworks, carpets, and two tables. Kept having dinner parties with a full guest list to trap every Sim in there until I wiped out every neighborhood, children included. When I was young, I would make Sims for the sole purpose of killing them off in different ways. Each room would be completely different. Example, one room completely empty, another room with a carpet and a fireplace, one with a cow plant, etc. And I would get such a kick out of it.
Breed humans to sell to wealthy vampire families.
When I was younger, I used to make the step-siblings and cousins have relationships. It doesn't feel right now, though. I wouldn't do it again. I used to make some dramatic and weird storylines. I blame them Sims 2 videos I used to watch on YouTube. I had two vampire lady Sims, one mom and teen daughter, who kidnapped stinky men and kept them as a plasma source. Feminism. I made a robot couple go from house to house murdering everyone they saw and kidnapping their children to their basement and letting them starve, and anyone that was casually walking across the street would be murdered mercilessly, and I went through all the interactions of murder. I wanted my family to live in a haunted house that used to be an orphanage, so I made a matron, adopted a ton of kids, 7 at the time because this was before I used mods, and then locked the kids in a basement with a pool and a fire room. The graveyard ended up having over 30 graves. Made a Sim that liked to woohoo their victims before violently murdering them, just cause I thought it'd be more interesting than the weird ass Dexter situation my usual murder Sim has going on. I had a vampire family who lured unsuspecting Sims into their basement where they kept them as prisoners and fed off of them. The vampires also had a Targaryen thing going on and would marry their own family members. My Sim had a baby with Caleb Vator, then he left her for a Caliente, and because the kid was a vampire, she hated the kid too and locked it in the attic her whole life. The kid then ran away to live with Caleb, and then he sold her to Vlad. Good times. I had a Sim that I didn't care for, so I was trying to drown her in a pool. She was pregnant, so she wouldn't die, so I forced her to have a baby, and it was an alien baby, and then she drowned. One time this girl bullied me, so my friends and I went home, made her in The Sims, and killed her in every way possible. Made a Sim that looked like a skinny Shrek with pink hair, put him in a room with massive windows as walls so he could see outside but never leave. Gave him only a fireplace and sized down the sofa until he died. Not me, but my friend as a kid slept over and I was scared of the dark, so I kept the lights on, and she wasn't, so she killed all of my Sims while I slept. I really respect her for it. Not in The Sims 4, but once in The Sims 3, one of my Sims accidentally got pregnant, but I didn't want her to have kids, so once the baby was born, I left it on a carpet next to the fireplace, hoping that it would catch fire and die. The carpet caught fire, as always, but the baby never died. I also once made a criminal with high fertility impregnate half of Sunset Valley. He'd get a girlfriend, get her pregnant, dump her, kick her out when she was heavily pregnant and about to pop with twins or triplets, and then get another girlfriend, also in The Sims 3. Those days were wild. The first time I played, I didn't know build mode existed, and my newborn baby needed a bassinet, so he kept crying until my Sims got so sick of it. I kept the crying baby outside far from my house so the Sims could never hear him. I was messing about with werewolves and another Sim died. The werewolf started pissing on the corpse. Margaret Thatcher Simulator. Got a Sim, kidnapped a bunch of people to be in a cult, changed their name to be her last name, woohooed with the men I took, who were always married, and as soon as I knew the cult lady was pregnant, I just sacrificed the men. In The Sims 3, I made a game where I would go after taken men specifically, make them break up or divorce their partner, then after trying for a baby with them, I would kill them with my Dexter mod. I stole Bob pancakes from Eliza, burnt their house down, added her to my family, made her and Bob flirt to give her hope, teleported her to the bedroom to watch me and Bob woohoo, and then locked her in the swimming pool with our pictures.
I used the cats and dogs window, but the green swatch.
I didn't do it, but the game and mod did. This had the Wicked Whims mod. My two characters decided to go on a date to a restaurant. Went outside, had the hanky-lanky in public, then one of them took a dump in the other's face and stomped it into their mouth. Made my friends and I Sims-selves jump Caleb Vator at the Brindleton Bay pub. He was bald and limping when we were done with him. I made a vampirist master, and in her mansion, she had a beautiful collection of ready-to-devour goods. She kept each of them in a closed room and would switch which room she spent her days and nights in every day. She also often went hunting for new members in town. As a wee 7-year-old playing the OG Sims, my favorite thing to do was put my Sims alone in a room with no doors and nothing but fireworks, making them light each one and watch them burn to death. I did this repeatedly. Killed Bella Goth by starving her so my Sim could marry her husband and be rich. I wanted to have a sim get pregnant with one of her buddies. When she was finally eating for two, I assumed it was from a specific sim I had in mind. When she gave birth and I found out that it was a different dad, I cheated the game so it could be taken by child services. I'm just saying, The Sims 1 only gave you a cute little white headstone for child sims. Kinda hard to pinpoint one in The Sims 4. Most disturbing thing I can think of in The Sims 3 was where I locked a bunch of elders in a room to slowly starve because they refused to leave my house after a party. Only one made it out, refusing to die, so I let her go. She was a fighter. I made 8 characters try and survive a complicated labyrinth of a house, and the winner was forced to have 8 more kids, and the kids had to do the same exact thing, and it just repeated. First time playing The Sims 2 at a friend's house. We were 11. We made a couple had a baby, and then put the baby in front of a fire, hoping it would catch a light. It didn't work, so we put the baby out in the snow, and it got taken away. I remember crying laughing at the whole thing. I downloaded Wicked Wimp solely so that I could make the cast of Twilight ahead of the werewolf update, and made a strip club slash brothel with Esme as the owner and had her pimp out her children. And when the werewolf pack came out, I made Jacob and had him do unspeakable things to Edward. My sim almost died and was saved by her husband, then cheated on him with a younger dude, and then I had the husband get eaten by a cow plant. Also, I accidentally clicked a button and my baby disappeared. Made Ned Fulmer only to kill him. Bella showed up and started flirting with my sim's fiance, so I waited for her to go into an unused room and lock the door for everyone. Then I simply forgot about her. Made my sim have a lot of babies, locked the mother in a room, then watched one by one as the babies were taken away. I had my toddler kill his mom because I needed the Grim Reaper to show up because I wanted to know if he would get naked if I woohooed with him. He did not. Impregnated every female in town in The Sims 3. The school is packed with all of my children. They can't get in. I had more children in a household I was playing than I wanted, so I had her go outside in a bathing suit during a blizzard and she froze to death. Oh, and this is all while her mother was drowning people in her hidden dungeon. My sim flirted with a guy, but he was rejected, so I locked his entire family in the basement and used the extreme violence mod to have my sim enact his revenge by eliminating the rejector's family one by one. Then he left the rejector alone in his basement, Lamel. Are you okay? Before this video ends, I just want to thank my amazing simps over at Patreon for funding this video and for funding me and making sure that I can eat and drink and my cat can eat and drink and, you know, you just... Thank you.